Sri Paramahamsa, Pri Rajacharya Sutra Sattva Sri Samadhi Divine Grace, Charabhavi Charananda Bhaktivedanta Swami, Sri Prabhupada, Ananta Koti Vaishnava Vrindi, Skandiviti Sankarshaya Divine Grace, Sri Prabhupada, Namacharya Sri Haridas Thakur Ki, Samadhi Bhakta Vrindi, Hari Nama Sankirtana Ki, Grantha Rashma Bhagavatam Ki, Jayanta Gaur Divinandi, all Velicity Samadhuddhis, all Velicity Samadhuddhis, all Velicity Samadhuddhis, all Velicity Sri Guru Dusi Gauranga, all Velicity Sri Prabhupada. Om Avyati Randasya Gyananjana Sarakaya Dakshavindritam Jenitam Tasmai Sri Dhrubhidhama Sri Chaitanya Omnisana Stavitam Jena Bhuttale Svayam Rupakadamayam Tadati Svabhradikam Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Juta Padakamanda Sri Guru Vaishnavanscha Sri Rupamam Sahabratatam Sahadam Raghunatam Vitam Tvam Sahivam Sadvedam Sadhutam Parijana Saitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakam Vitam Sahara Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dunya Bandhu Jagapate Gaurisha Bhikha Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Kanta Kanchana Kodangi Radhe Vinda Vaneshwari
all blissful and all perfect. कर्तव्यादिषु याः परा
श्रीसुकवाचाश्नालोकं
हिते नृपात्मविसमत
पुंसाव्यादिषु
या परा
श्रीसुकवाच
Shri Sukadeva Goswami berkata, wahai raja yang baik, Pertanyaan Anda begitu mulia karena hal itu sangat bermanfaat bagi semua orang. Jawaban pertanyaan ini adalah pokok bahasan utama untuk didengarkan dan ini dibenarkan oleh semua rohaniwan.
Report. Even the very question is so nice that it is the best subject matter for hearing.
Bahkan pertanyaan yang diajukan itu pun begitu bagus sehingga pertanyaan itu merupakan pokok bahasan yang terbaik untuk didengarkan.
Simply by such questioning and hearing, one can achieve the highest perfectional stage of life.
Hanya dengan cara bertanya dan mendengarkan seperti itu, seseorang dapat mencapai tingkat kesempurnaan tertinggi dalam kehidupan.
Because Lord Krishna is the original supreme person, any question about him is original and perfect.
Karena Sri Krishna adalah personalitas tertinggi yang asli, maka setiap pertanyaan yang diajukan berhubungan dengan Krishna adalah asli dan sempurna.
Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said that the highest perfection of life is to achieve the transcendental loving service of Krishna.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mengatakan bahwa kesempurnaan hidup yang tertinggi ialah mencapai pelayanan dalam cinta kasih rohani kepada Krishna.
Because questions and answers about Krishna elevate one to the transcendental position, the questions of Maharaj Parikshit about Krishna philosophy are greatly glorified.
Karena kegiatan tanya jawab tentang Krishna bisa mengangkat seseorang untuk mencapai kedudukan rohani, maka pertanyaan Maharaja Parikshit yang berhubungan dengan filsafat Krishna sangatlah luhur.
Maharaja Parikshit wanted to absorb his mind completely in Krishna, and such absorption can be effected simply by hearing about the uncommon activities of Krishna.
Maharaj Parikshit sepenuhnya ingin membenamkan pikirannya tertuju pada Krishna, dan kekusukan seperti itu dapat dicapai hanya dengan mendengarkan tentang kegiatan rohani Krishna.
For instance, in the Bhagavad Gita it is stated that simply by understanding the transcendental nature of Lord Krishna's appearance, disappearance, and activities, one can immediately return home back to Godhead and never come back to this miserable condition of material existence.
Misalnya, di dalam Bhagavad Gita dinyatakan bahwa hanya dengan mengerti sifat rohani tentang kemunculan, kepergian, dan kegiatan Krishna, maka seorang segera kembali pulang, kembali kepada Tuhan, dan tidak pernah kembali lagi dalam kehidupan material yang menyedihkan ini.
It is very auspicious, therefore, to hear always about Krishna.
Karena itu amatlah bermanfaat untuk selalu mendengarkan tentang Krishna.
So Maharaj Parikshit requested Shukadeva Goswami to narrate the activities of Krishna so that he could engage his mind in Krishna.
Demikianlah Maharaja Parikshit memohon kepada Sukadeva Goswami untuk menceritakan kegiatan-kegiatan Krishna sehingga ia bisa memusatkan pikirannya kepada Krishna.
The activities of Krishna are not different from Krishna himself.
Kegiatan Krishna identik atau sama dengan Krishna sendiri.
As long as one is engaged in hearing such transcendental activities of Krishna, he remains aloof from the conditional life of material existence.
Selama seseorang tekun mendengarkan tentang kegiatan rohani Krishna, maka dia akan tetap menyisih dari kegiatan material.
The topics of Lord Krishna are so auspicious that they purify the speaker, the hearer, and the inquirer.
Topik-topik tentang Krishna berikut berdua sehingga hal itu dapat menyucikan pembicara, pendengar, dan yang bertanya.
And they are compared to the Ganges waters which flow from the toes of Lord Krishna.
Hal itu laksana air sungai Gangga yang mengalir dari kaki Lord Krishna.
And wherever the Ganges waters flow, they purify the land and the person who bathes in them.
Hal itu laksana air sungai Gangga yang mengalir dari kaki Lord Krishna. Dimanapun sungai Gangga mengalir, airnya akan menyucikan tanah dan orang-orang yang mandi di sana.
Similarly, Krishna Katha, or the topics of Krishna, are so pure that wherever they are spoken, the place, the hearer, the inquirer, the speaker, and all concerned become purified.
Begitu pula Krishna Katha, topik-topik tentang Krishna begitu murni, sehingga dimanapun topik itu disampaikan, tempat pendengar yang bertanya, pembicara, dan semua yang berkaitan disucikan.
Translation again, Sri Shukadeva Goswami said, my dear king, your question is glorious because it is very beneficial to all kinds of people. The answer to this question is a prime subject matter for hearing and it is approved by all transcendental.
Sri Sukadeva Goswami berkata, wahai raja yang baik, pertanyaan Anda begitu mulia, karena hal itu sangat bermanfaat bagi semua orang. Jawaban pertanyaan ini adalah pokok bahasan utama untuk didengarkan dan ini dibenarkan oleh semua rohaniwan.
One of the very unique and special qualities of Srila Prabhupada is that he has been able to insert the word Krishna very extensively throughout his writings, especially like if we count how many times the word Krishna comes up, it's like Prabhupada is repeating, and whenever the opportunity is there, he is inserting that transcendental name of Krishna.
Salah satu sifat yang unik dan istimewa dari Srila Prabhupada adalah kapanpun ada kesempatan, beliau selalu berusaha memasukkan nama rohani Sri Krishna.
Yeah. In other words, Srila Prabhupada was so intensely Krishna conscious that whenever he spoke, the word Krishna, Krishna, Krishna would come out many, many times.
Oleh karena itu, kita bisa mengetahui bahwa Srila Prabhupada adalah sosok yang sadar akan Krishna sepenuhnya. Dan kapanpun beliau berbicara, nama suci Krishna terus-menerus keluar.
Yes. In many ways, Srila Prabhupada's Bhagavad Gita is very unique in that the word Krishna, reference to the Lord Krishna, is practically found in every page. In every page of the Bhagavad Gita, practically, Srila Prabhupada has inserted Krishna as he has in this particular purport also.
Misalnya, Bhagavad Gita yang diterjemahkan oleh Srila Prabhupada begitu unik sekali, dan beliau senantiasa menyisipkan kata Krishna di sana, dan begitu pula dalam penjelasan dari sloka ini, Sri Prabhupada juga memasukkan nama Krishna berkali-kali.
So this is Shukadeva Goswami who is beginning to respond to the many questions that were asked by Parikshit Maharaj in the last chapter of the first canto that we just finished yesterday.
Jadi ini adalah awal bagaimana Sukadeva Goswami merespon berbagai pertanyaan dari Maharaj prinsip di bab sebelumnya.
So I think all of us have the experience if we meet some new person and if that person is asking what we consider nice question that gives us an opportunity to speak about Krishna, then the devotees become very happy, as opposed to meeting somebody who's asking mundane questions. Most people, they ask mundane questions that are not relevant to the real purpose of life.
Jadi misalnya kalau ada orang baru yang bertanya tentang berbagai hal tentang selain Krishna, biasanya para penyimak sangat senang sekali karena dia melihat kesempatan untuk menyampaikan tentang Krishna. Dan seperti juga orang-orang yang orang-orang yang bukan penyimak yang bertanya tentang hal-hal yang bersifat material yang tidak ada hubungannya dengan kehidupan.
Yes, because by nature personalities like Shukadeva Goswami, they become very enlivened when someone is asking such type of questions pertaining to the real goal and purpose of life.
Karena sosok seperti Shukadeva Goswami ini merasa sangat senang sekali ketika pertanyaan-pertanyaan yang diajukan itu berhubungan dengan tujuan kehidupan.
Because actually we come to hear, we come to know from Shastra that the perfection of life is actually to know and to remember Krishna, especially at the moment of death.
Karena kesempurnaan hidup yang dijelaskan oleh Shastra adalah kita harus tahu Krishna dan bisa mengingat Krishna pada saat akan menjelang meninggalkan badan ini.
Ante Narayana Smriti, at the end of life, the perfection for an individual is to be able to remember Narayana or Krishna.
Ante Narayana Smriti, artinya seseorang kayaknya mengingat Narayana atau Krishna pada saat akan meninggalkan badannya.
So in the third point, the Srila Prabhupada nicely explained also that whenever there are discussions about Krishna in relation to Krishna, the person speaking, the person who's hearing, and the whole, all other living entities, they all benefit from that transcendental sound vibration connected with Krishna.
Dan sebagaimana yang dijelaskan oleh Srila Prabhupada dalam penjelasan ini bahwa kapanpun topik-topik Krishna itu didiskusikan, baik yang pembicara, pendengar, dan semua makhluk hidup di sekitarnya itu disucikan dengan nama suci Krishna yang bersifat rohani.
There are actually recordings of Srila Prabhupada in the early days. Prabhupada made a point of recording all of his lectures, and there are a few recordings we come to know when there was nobody in the class. Still, Prabhupada gave the class.
Di awal-awal masa Srila Prabhupada menyebarkan saran Krishna, beliau biasanya membuat rekaman kelas-kelas beliau. Dan beberapa dari kelas-kelas beliau tetap rekam meskipun tidak ada yang mendengarkan.
Because then Prabhupada, he would give the example of his Guru Maharaj that even if no one comes from the class, the four walls will hear. The four walls. Because in the walls, there's living entities everywhere, right? They will hear.
Dan Srila Prabhupada mengutip contoh seperti Guru Maharaj beliau, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, mengatakan bahkan kalau tidak ada yang datang pada saat kelas, tembok-tembok pun tetap mendengarkan karena di sana pasti ada makhluk hidup. Jadi tetap ada pendengar yang datang.
Yeah, we're not alone.
Kita tidak sendiri.
And of course, Srila Prabhupada, he recording his classes in the future, people will be hearing.
Dan Srila Prabhupada mengetahui dengan baik bahwa rekaman yang beliau buat akan didengarkan oleh orang-orang di masa depan.
One time Srila Prabhupada was explaining how mundane, ordinary sound vibration, it goes around, according to scientists, it goes around the planet like 7 or 8 times within a very short time. Within a second or two, any sound vibration goes around the planet 7 times. That's the power of sound.
Menurut para ilmuwan, katanya suara-suara yang bersifat material itu pergi ke seluruh planet.
Yes, 7 times. Yeah, they say.
Yeah, yeah, para ilmuwan muter 7 kali kayak itu.
But Prabhupada explained that transcendental sound vibration. Is that the transcendental sound vibration remains forever? It never it becomes extinct like mundane sound vibration. That means that when we speak about Krishna, Katha, when we chant the holy name, this sound vibration, being transcendental, has continuous benefit for so many.
Tetapi Srila Prabhupada menjelaskan bagaimana suara rohani ini bersifat kekal ya, terus menerus sehingga bisa memberikan manfaat kepada semua makhluk hidup.
Yes. So throughout the Srimad Bhagavatam and also when we think about the Goswamis of Vrindavan, for example, and they were in Vrindavan simply discussing every day for many hours, they would simply sit, read, and discuss matters of Krishna Katha.
Seperti halnya saat Goswami Vrindavan, mereka menghabiskan berjam-jam waktunya di Vrindavan untuk duduk, membaca, dan mendiskusikan topik-topik tentang Krishna.
In other words, we should be arranging our life in such a way that is the whole purpose, actually, the Vedic culture. Vedic culture is arranged in a simple way so that one is able to find maximum time for Krishna Katha.
Dan itu artinya bahwa seorang hendaknya mengatur hidupnya sedemikian rupa, seperti misalnya kebudayaan Weda. Budaya Weda itu bertujuan sebenarnya untuk bagaimana mengatur kehidupan kita supaya waktu itu bisa digunakan lebih banyak untuk Krishna Katha.
Prabhupada would sometimes mention how people in the Western countries, they criticize people in India, they criticize the people in India for not being interested in advancement, in economic development and advancement.
Srila Prabhupada mengatakan bagaimana orang-orang Barat itu mengkritik orang-orang India karena mereka tidak tertarik dengan perkembangan ekonomi dan kemajuan.
Yeah. But we know that due to modern advancement in the Western countries, especially people, they are very advanced materially, but in order to have advanced in this way materially, they have given up practically all activities of the spiritual nature.
Tetapi kita tahu bahwa dengan sebenarnya menjadi maju secara spiritual, yang maju secara material, mereka meninggalkan kehidupan spiritual.
Yeah. So Vedic culture therefore advocates, encourages, and actually is arranged in such a way that we keep our life more simple, purposely for saving time to practice and discuss about Krishna consciousness.
Oleh karena itu, kebudayaan Weda sebenarnya membantu kita mengatur kehidupan kita sedemikian rupa supaya bisa menjadi lebih sederhana dan lebih banyak waktu untuk mendengarkan tentang Krishna.
We know how in the Western countries especially, people are mad after, in the name of economic development, in the name of material advancement, they are engaged in so many material activities, the end result being that they totally forget about what is the purpose of life.
Jadi orang-orang di barat itu yang disebut sebagai orang yang maju di zaman modern sangat tergila-gila dengan perkembangan ekonomi dan ya sebagai akibatnya tidak tertarik dengan kehidupan spiritual.
Actually, the Bhagavatam, especially the seventh canto, for example, where Narada Muni speaks to Yudhishthira Maharaj about Varnashrama Dharma, it is explained, Narada Muni explained that actually, how even householders should not be so preoccupied with making money.
Narada Muni bersabda kepada Maharaja Yudhishthira di Srimad Bhagavatam Skanda 7, bahwa bahkan orang-orang yang berumah tangga sekalipun tidak boleh terlalu banyak waktunya digunakan untuk mencari kekayaan.
Devotee is someone who understand that actually my material situation in this life, whether I will be rich or poor, whether I will be healthy or not healthy, this is all determined by my previous activities. Due to karma, it's already determined and established how my material condition will be in this life.
Jadi, seorang tanya menyadari bahwa baik kita kaya maupun miskin, sehat maupun tidak sehat, ini semua disebabkan oleh kegiatan masa lalu kita, karma kita sebelumnya.
We are reaping or getting the results of our previous activities from previous lifetimes in this life.
Jadi kita mendapatkan segala hasil perbuatan kita di masa lalu di kehidupan ini.
The prime business, the prime purpose for all those living entities who are fortunate to have a human form of life is to strive for self-realization.
Oleh karena itu, kehidupan manusia ini hendaknya dimaksudkan untuk keinsafan diri.
Yeah, especially Prabhupada explains how society, as we know, is divided brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, and sannyas. Especially those who are brahmacharis, saffron color, those who are vanaprastha and sannyas, their only business is simply to strive for spiritual advancement.
Khususnya masyarakat, baik brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, sannyas, khususnya brahmachari, vanaprastha, dan sannyas, hendaknya menggunakan hidupnya sepenuhnya untuk keinsafan diri.
Yeah. And even those who are householders, they should not over endeavor for material advancement.
Dan bahkan bagi yang berumah tangga, hendaknya tidak terlalu keras untuk berusaha mengumpulkan kekayaan.
So therefore, modern day society is in many ways dangerous because Prabhupada explains the more we surround ourselves and become involved with material so-called advancement, the danger, the tendency is to actually minimize the time for spiritual activities.
Oleh karena itu, yang disebut sebagai zaman modern saat ini sebenarnya meminimalisir waktu kita dari berbagai hal supaya tidak mendapatkan kesempatan. memisahkan diri.
Even for our own devotees, we find very often devotees having difficulty to chant their 16 rounds every day.
Bahkan kita menemukan penyembah kita itu mengalami kesulitan untuk menyelesaikan 16 putaran japanya setiap hari.
So this very important point which is being introduced here, and this whole chapter was especially emphasized the importance of chanting the holy name and giving maximum amount of time to perform spiritual activities.
Oleh karena itu, bab ini akan menjelaskan kepada kita nantinya tentang keagungan dari nama suci Tuhan dan bagaimana kita bisa menggunakan waktu kita secara maksimal untuk kegiatan-kegiatan spiritual.
Yeah. But even so-called material activities, if we perform them as instructed in the Shastra and with intent of pleasing Krishna, those so-called material activities also become spiritualized.
Misalnya meskipun kegiatan material yang kita lakukan sehari-hari, tapi kalau itu berdasarkan sastra dan niat kita sebenarnya melakukan hal itu untuk keinsafan diri, maka kegiatan material itu akan berubah menjadi kegiatan spiritual.
So the topic of prescribed duties, which is mentioned both in the Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam, there are prescribed duties that are very nicely, clearly defined in the Shastra, that we should know.
Jadi dalam sastra, baik Bhagavad Gita maupun Srimad Bhagavatam, ada tugas-tugas kewajiban yang telah ditetapkan dan dijelaskan dengan jelas.
Yeah. Most people in the world today, they are not performing the prescribed duties.
Kebanyakan orang di zaman sekarang sebenarnya tidak melakukan tugas kewajiban yang telah ditetapkan.
Many of our devotees are also not performing the prescribed duties.
Kebanyakan di dalam penyembah kita tidak melakukan tugas kewajiban yang telah ditetapkan.
Yeah. That's a big topic actually, which takes a little bit of time, which we don't really have this morning. But very important for devotees to understand what is the meaning of prescribed duties.
Kita mungkin gagal untuk mendiskusikannya lebih lanjut, tetapi hal yang penting untuk dipahami adalah apa sebenarnya yang dimaksud dengan tugas dan kewajiban yang telah ditetapkan.
Prescribed duties are especially those duties, duties means activities, which more easily help us to remember Krishna and those activities that are pleasing to Krishna.
Tugas kewajiban artinya kegiatan, kewajiban itu juga artinya kegiatan yang kita itu mudah melaksanakannya dan sekaligus memuaskan Krishna sesuai dengan sifat kita.
And again, the example for all of us are the residents of Vrindavan. The kind of activities for householders, for everyone actually in society, we get the example, the ideal example is from the residents of Vrindavan.
Contoh idealnya itu adalah diterapkan oleh para penduduk Vrindavan.
Yeah. And that is why we should strive, we should endeavor to make Vrindavan.
Oleh karena itu kita harus berusaha untuk membuat desa-desa Vrindavan.
Siapa mau tinggal di Vrindavan?
Who wants to stay in Vrindavan?
Yeah. So to stay in Vrindavan, we have to know what the residents of Vrindavan are doing all the time.
Kalau kita ingin tinggal di Vrindavan, kita harus tahu kegiatan sehari-hari para penduduk Vrindavan.
Yeah. Most of the time, they're connected with looking after cows and looking after the land.
Dan sebagian waktu mereka dihabiskan untuk memelihara sapi dan mengurusi tanah.
And they were constantly remembering Krishna's pastimes.
Dan mereka secara terus-menerus mengingat kegiatan.
Constantly discussing things in relation to Krishna.
Secara terus-menerus mendiskusikan sesuatu yang berhubungan dengan Krishna.
So we can take the last few minutes that are there. We really do have to finish at 9 o'clock today. Anyway, today is not Sunday, so if there's any comments or questions, we can take a few minutes.
Yeah, I'll add that one again. Yes, sir.
He's trying to make Vrindavan in Puri Dham.
Prabhunya berusaha membuat Vrindavan di Puri Dham.
Kalau pikir cara rohani, benar kalau kita tergantung dengan sapi dengan tanah, tapi kalau kita minta material terus melayani sapi tanah, terus masalah berasnya datang dari mana itu
pertanyaannya.
Ya itu kalau kita melayani sapi tanah, terus kalau kita pikir nanti untuk beras dari mana itu maksudnya
kebutuhan
sehari-harinya
dari tanah itu.
From the perspective of Shastra, if we are taking care properly of cows and lamb, we will get all material necessities. But nowadays, people are thinking, where we can get rice if we are just taking care of the cows and lamb?
Where we can get rice?
Yeah, nasi.
Yeah, I know.
Where the other necessities of our life we can get if we are just taking care of cows and land, how to overcome this type of mentality?
How to overcome the mentality of where to get rice?
Food and other necessities.
Our mentality is that for us, we're not concerned. We want to get rice to offer to Krishna.
Jadi sikap yang tepat itu untuk kita dapat nasi nggak nasi sebenarnya nggak masalah, tapi kita mau dapat nasi supaya bisa offering, bukan untuk makan saja.
Yeah, our primary goal in the world is how to satisfy Krishna, how to please Krishna, and how to please those who are very dear to Krishna. So not only we give food to Krishna, but also we want to give food to the Vaishnavas, to the devotees.
Jadi kita harus punya pemikiran agar bagaimana kita bisa dapatkan nasi ini atau makanan ini untuk Krishna dan juga penyembah Krishna. Seperti itu harusnya pola pikir.
Yeah, whatever it is we want to do, like the residents of Vrindavan, just naturally they give their maximum time for the cows and also for the land, and automatically all of their necessities of life are met.
Jadi contoh yang nyata itu adalah para penduduk Vrindavan yang sebagian besar menghabiskan waktunya bersama sapi dan tanah. Kenyataannya semua kebutuhan sehari-harinya terpenuhi.
Yeah. I'm not sure if that's answering your question.
Yes. Kayaknya udah menjawab pertanyaannya.
Sometimes we have to fine tune our question. He's asking that why we should have this preoccupation of producing. Why we should be preoccupied with producing food?
Kenapa kita preoccupied?
Is that his question?
His question is that where we can get food if we just taking care of the cows.
Where we can get food?
Food like rice. How can rice and food come if we are just taking care of the cows and land? That is his question.
If we knows a man, the rice will come automatically. All the food, all of the necessities, all of the necessities of life are met when we know, when we learn the art and the science of looking after cows, and the art and science of looking after bumi, the land.
Sebenarnya nasi itu datang dari bumi, tanah. Jadi kalau kita merawat sapi dan tanah, nasi dan makanannya akan datang. Jadi ada sains atau pengetahuan di balik hal itu. Kalau kita mempelajarinya dengan baik, maka nasi akan datang atau makanan akan datang. Masalahnya kita nggak tahu.
It is a very great science, actually, how to properly care for cows and how to properly care for the land. Now, in some places, like in Canada, rice doesn't grow. So not all the, you know, Krishna arranges for different food to grow in different places, for different kinds of cows to stay in different locations.
Jadi sebenarnya ada pengetahuan yang sangat mulia tentang bagaimana cara untuk merawat sapi dan tanah itu dengan baik. Contohnya misalnya di Kanada itu nggak ada nasi, nggak ada beras, tapi orang bisa hidup dengan makanan yang lain. Nah, begitu pula sapi di berbagai tempat, tanah di berbagai tempat itu kita harus tahu bagaimana, ada pengetahuan yang harus kita pelajari di sana untuk bagaimana mendapatkan makanan dari berbagai tempat.
Someone is thank you. Somebody wants to give Bhagavatam class.
Mau ada Bhagavatam tandingan.
Any other?
Kalau di Nausa Prabu Nausa.
Oh, iya.
Kalau di kebun kita kan tiang pribadi sering muter lagu. Kalau apakah ada perbedaan vibrasi antara lagu yang datang dari HP dengan lagu yang kita nyanyikan sendiri? Sebab kalau kita bernyanyi sambil berkebun capek Prabu gitu. Jadi dia sering muter dari lagu dari HP. Gitu.
Sambil segernya
sambil landur ya, sambil berkebun
itu penumbang
itu keuntungan terhadap pohon itu apa lagu rohani apa bu ya?
When he is funny, he used to play music
Krishna music
kadang-kadang Krishna music.
And is there any difference when you play music by phone? And he himself,
the difference between music over the phone or chanting, ourselves.
Yeah. Because when he is farming, if he is chanting, he becomes tired.
No, not if he learned how to chant properly.
Sekarang waktunya untuk belajar menyanyi dengan baik sambil berkebun.
Lebih baik dari pribadi. Actually, it is even today in some places in India, maybe here in Indonesia, the people who are farming, they chant all day. They have different songs in relation to the land or in relation to it was the custom. That people who were, because usually they're alone working in the field, or they might be with others. So there's many kinds of folk type of songs that people would chant.
Dulu itu merupakan sebuah kebiasaan mungkin di India dan juga di Indonesia. Kadang mereka harus pergi ke ladang sendiri ataupun berbanyak. Tapi mereka tetap bisa menyanyi terus-menerus sambil bertani.
Such kind of sound vibration is very conducive, very helpful. But the type of sound vibration coming out of these machines, your machine, my machine. Actually, we should not bring our machines in the field because cell phones, you know, we don't see, but cell phones are full of very destructive energies.
Yes.
Therefore, we have this practice in India, you might know, that we put a special chip, not potato chip. This is a special chip that counteracts the negative energies coming from cell phones. And this is made from cow dung.
Cow dung? Jadi perbedaan bertani idealnya kita hanya bisa menyanyi sambil bertani langsung secara langsung seperti itu. Jadi tidak memutar musik sambil bertani karena musik yang kita putar dari mesin dari HP ini sebenarnya penuh dengan hal-hal yang bisa merugikan tanaman.
Radiasi.
Radiasinya merugikan, berpengaruh terhadap kesehatan tanaman. Dan untuk menetralisir mesin ini dipasanglah chip ini. Kartu ini yang terbuat dari kotoran sapi, tahu kan?
Yes, I highly recommend to all the devotees. You can make your own.
Gimana caranya di rumah?
How to make it?
How long is just sitting there?
No, I mean, you just wrap it.
Yeah, you just put it on some piece of paper, make it dry, and put it in between your cell phone and your cover.
Dengan anu ya?
Ya, kotoran sapi yang kering katanya dibungkus sebagai kertas, terus tempel di HP.
Oh iya.
So this is cell phone with a chip behind that some people can make a little fancy like this, but you can make your own. You can make your own. Just some piece of paper, put some cow dung, it will dry, and then put it in between your cell phone and your cover like this.
Chip ini bisa dibuat sendiri-sendiri oleh para penimbang. Jadi dikeringkan kotoran sapi, dibungkus kayak kertas, atau bisa mungkin dimodif sedikit biar mudah bel kayak ini.
That's like, that's why cell phones we should not keep in our pocket close to the heart, especially. We should not keep on our body close to the body.
Karena itu mesin-mesin yang beradiasi seperti ini hanya tidak ditaruh dekat dengan badan. Atau lagi menempel dengan badan, misalnya di dekat jantung.
And that's why like this also is very bad.
Dan telepon seperti ini juga sangat berpengaruh radiasi HP pada kesehatan kita.
All types of radioactive negative energies that are actually destroying nature in so many ways, destroying our own body.
Jadi dari mesin ini banyak sekali energi negatif yang bisa merugikan atau menghancurkan alam dan badan kita.
We may think, oh, such a nice machine, yeah, but this very nice machine is extremely destructive and dangerous.
Tapi mungkin kita berpikir, oh, ada mesin yang bagus, tetapi sebenarnya itu adalah mesin yang berbahaya.
Yeah. Next time, when we come, we'll give a whole class just on that topic.
Nanti kemudian beliau selanjutnya dia akan kasih kelas tentang mesin bahaya ada mesin.
Yeah. Okay, I think we were not able to follow.
Ada lagi? Tanya.
No. Even if there is, I have to go.
Okay. We are just the commands.
So thank you all very much. Can we continue? Actually, everyone should help to remove fully the cow dung from the goshala.
Jadi terima kasih banyak para bima sudah datang dan PR selanjutnya adalah agar semua para bima bisa membantu memindahkan setelan sapi yang ada di Gusala ke tempat lainnya.
It's like when we come in contact with the way Krishna, we become purified. When we come in contact with cow dung, we also become purified.
Seperti ada kalau kita terhubung dengan Krishna, kita akan disucikan. Begitu juga kalau kita terhubung dengan kotoran sapi, kita juga disucikan.
Jai Ratnasya Bhagavatam Ki
Jai.
Jai Sri Prabhupada Ki
Jai.
Jai Samasta Gaura Bhaktavrinda
Ki
Jai.
Jai.
Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai. Jai.